myself have never had the problem of being short. When I was a child, when I was, you know, 5, 6, 7, 8 or so, I was more or less average with everybody else. And I got my growth spurt like around 12, 13, like that. And for a time, I was one of the tallest kids in my class. In point of fact, I grew so quickly that because of it, I've always had poor posture because I've always sort of like leaned over. You see what I mean? By the time I was 18, I was sort of like, you know, run of the mill. The fact of the matter is that today, at 51, I weigh exactly 1.80 meters, which I think is 5'11 and a quarter or something like that, you know, not quite 6 feet, which is kind of funny because, see, when I was 19, I was actually 181 and change. I was actually 6 feet on the money. Yeah. So between the times I was 19 and now 51, I've actually shrunk a little bit, which is very amusing, actually. So I never had the insecurity of being short, but I've seen guys who are insecure about their height. And more importantly, I've seen guys who have successfully handled the fact that they're short. You see, I like tall girls. I like girls who are like 5'8 and up. Okay, it's always been my type. I like them tall and thin. You know, that's me, that's my stereotype, that's my taste, you know, proclivity, call it what you will. My bias, my whatever kind of ism the left wants to call it, right? I like them thin and I like them tall. And I've dated girls who are like 6 feet. I've dated a couple who are taller than me. I mean, like, you know, like noticeably taller than me. And a bunch of girlfriends have been taller than me when they're wearing heels, you know? I've never had a problem with that, right? I like tall girls. And, well, you know, and I'll bang short ones too, why not? But see, the thing I've noticed about short guys is that they're all hung up on it. And they don't realize that the very fact that they're short gives them an advantage that, oddly enough, they don't see. Let me explain. See, when a guy like me, you know, 6 feet or 180, whatever you want to call it, goes up to some girl, you know, some pretty girl, some attractive girl, you know, she's 5'6", 5'7", right? And she's fairly attractive. She's going to look at me as just another guy, right? And I'm going to have to prove myself to her, okay? Because that's what girls do. They want to make sure that the guy that they're looking at, that they're dealing with, is somebody worth their while, worth their time, right? And that's why girls do shit tests. They want to, they're basically compliance tests to make sure that the guy is up to snuff, right? And so when I approach a girl, any girl between, you know, 5'5 and 5'9, or how taller even, she's going to give me some shit tests automatically to make sure that I'm on the up and up. But a short guy who approaches a tall girl or a girl taller than him automatically is signaling something really important by his mere presence, by the mere fact that he's approaching her. He is broadcasting loud and clear something very important. What is he broadcasting? That he has balls. That's what he's broadcasting. Fuck yeah. When a 5'5 guy, a guy who is 5'5", approaches a girl who in her bare feet is 5'8", and she's standing in her heels at some party, and so now she's like 5'11", this short guy goes up to her with a big smile and starts chatting her up. You know what that girl automatically knows about this guy, about this little manlet, as some would despectively call him? She knows that he's got balls the size of watermelons. That's what she knows. And that's what she's interested in. Of course, because a woman wants to be with a guy who's got the gumption, the balls, the nerve, to go up to a girl 6 inches taller than him and chat her up. Because if he can do that, then he's probably on the ball insofar as his employment, probably on the ball insofar as money is concerned. If he's 5'5" and sharply dressed and he just comes up to her like he owns the room and looks up at her and smiles and starts chatting her and feeding her lines, she's going to pay attention to him. And that's the thing I've noticed, see? The short guys who just roll right up to the tall girls, the taller the better, they are successful with them. The girls automatically pay attention to him. even if he's short, and sometimes they pay more attention to him the shorter he is, because that attitude, that self-confidence, that sense that he is visibly shorter than the girl, and yet he's just rolling right up to her, right? That signals not just to that tall girl, but to everybody else, that the guy's got it. He's got a pair of watermelons between his legs. That's what it signals, and everybody knows it. And so that's why I've never quite understood this insecurity of short guys. You gotta have a lot of nerve to go up to a tall girl and talk her up, but if you do it, you gain incredible credibility. You gain, you know, street cred. Yeah, there's nothing else to call it that, because people will automatically realize that you're somebody to be taken seriously, precisely because you're short. See, a short guy who's a loser is never gonna roll up to the tall girl. A short guy who's a loser is not going to put himself out there. And that's the secret, and that's why I find it so frustrating when I get these notes from guys who self-identify as short, right? And a few of them have sent me pictures of themselves, right? And they are good-looking guys. They're just short. They're 5'5", you know, 5'6", maybe. And they're incredibly insecure about it, but they don't realize what they've got going for them, because that very deficiency that they have, and overcoming it with confidence and charisma and balls, and just like, you know, with what the fuckness, right? If they can overcome it just by the act of strolling up to the hottest thing at some bar or some club and chatting them, well, they will win every time. Now, of course, with all guys have to learn game. You can be systematic about it and learn from a pickup artist or some class like that, or you can do it like me, which is sort of like hit or miss, and I just learned over the decades, right? But the point is, you gotta learn game. You gotta learn how to handle girls. You gotta know what's a shit test, when it comes, what to do about it, how to handle a girl, okay? Now, game is for everybody, you know. Rich, poor, short, tall, ugly, attractive, you know, thin, fat, every guy has to learn game. And so a short guy who doesn't have game and goes up to the hottest thing and you know, doesn't know how to handle the interaction, yeah, he's gonna get blown the fuck out of the water, but it doesn't have to do with him being short. It has to do with him not knowing game, right? And if he'd been like Brad Pitt, and just tall and handsome and everything, but he doesn't have game, he'd get blown out just the same as a short guy. It has nothing to do with height. It has everything to do with game, with knowing how to handle the psychology of women, okay? But if a short guy knows game, if a short guy knows how to handle the social interaction with a woman and knows what to expect and knows how to deal with shit tests, right? He's untouchable. He's unbeatable. A short guy will clean up every fucking time, in every situation, insofar as women are concerned. Fuck yeah. And not just with women. It'll be at work, in social life, in business, everything. See, a short guy who has confidence, right? How can I put this? See, a tall guy is just average. He's just a regular guy. See, a short guy who's got confidence, people look at him different, treat him different, treat him with respect. A short guy with confidence has the world by the balls, because what happens is that everybody sees him and they automatically assume that for him to have that confidence, he must have overcome a lot of problems. He must have overcome a lot of obstacles and be somebody to be taken seriously. Oh yeah, a short guy with confidence, well, he's Napoleon now, isn't he? Yeah, because that's what Napoleon was. He was a short guy with confidence. Yeah, look at French history. Pay attention to Napoleon's career. Look it up. See, Napoleon, you know, he started off like practically he was gonna be like a math teacher or some shit like that. You know, and where did he wind up? This short guy, and not even that handsome, wound up emperor of Europe. That's where he wound up. You know, it was a coalition of all the nations of Europe had to band together to defeat him. The guy was the man, and he fucked the hot women, and he built the empire, the first French empire, for crying out loud. He was a man, and he was a short guy. And an ugly short guy, for crying out loud. I envy short guys. I mean, I really do. It sounds like I'm being facetious, but I'm not. See, because a short guy with confidence, you know, he will own the room. And people notice him. And you look around YouTube, as a matter of fact. Look at fucking Destiny. That little pipsqueak, right? Everybody laughs at him that he's a manlet and what have you. But, you know, he really is a center of gravity. He really has a lot of people circulating around him. And he's a short little guy. How the fuck you think that happened? Huh? The force of personality. And how do you gain force of personality? By putting yourself out there. By risking humiliation and ridicule. By making the effort. By strolling up to the hottest thing at the bar and trying out game, and of course failing the first time, the second time, the third time, the fourth time, and yet coming back again and again until you finally succeed. See? Life is a numbers game. And a lot of short guys, I've noticed, they think that they fail because they're short, and that's why they're never going to succeed. And I'm here to tell you, no, it has nothing to do with that. You fail if you're a short guy, not because you're short, but because you give up. You can't give up. Mm-mm. You know, giving up is simply not an option, see? Especially if you're short, see? Because it's the taller guys or the regular size guys. Yeah, they give up. Okay? The short guy, yeah, you can't give up. Mm-mm. I've known a lot of short men in my time, and they were all remarkable. Yeah. Short little manlets, right? I know one guy who was 5'4", and I think that he must have earned on his own, okay? Not inherited, not by luck, but by just sheer gumption. I think that he was like in the $200 to $300 million range. Yeah. And he was a short 5'4" guy. I mean, he was sort of like good looking, but like shrunk. And he had an enormous head, right? It was pretty goddamn funny. He looked like a boy, okay? He looked like, you know, like a boy. You know, big head, small body, that kind of situation. His wife towered over him, yeah? She was fucking hot. Oh, yeah. The third wife. Yeah. That could be you.